Welcome back to Pixie Dust Stitchers.
Welcome. We are at Black Rock.
Black Rock.
And it's noisy.
Sorry, we hope you can hear us.
Yes, they were going to be very busy at Acorns, so we weren't able to really use their space.
Yeah. So we apologize. There's music and there's grinding. Yeah. And
so if you like the music, that's great. It's a little added feature. I don't have to add it.
And for some of you who are new, I'm Stephanie.
And I'm Wendy.
Welcome.
Yes. This is our number 11,
yep.
And it is the 7th of August.
7th of August.
I can't believe summer is flying by.
Oh gosh, I know. The year is flying by.
It's ridiculous.
I mean, it's literally, I feel, it's going, I'm going to blink my eyes and it's going to be Christmas.
Yes. Yeah.
Where has the year gone? It's unbelievable.
I don't know.
My mom always has told me, like, as I would grow up, she's like, just wait. The older you get, the faster it goes. And of course, when you're a kid and you're in school, you're thinking it's never going to go fast. Oh, it's true. I can't imagine it going any faster than it already does, but it goes fast. Enjoy today, people.
Yeah. All right. We're going to jump in and talk about
this. Jumping on in.
I'm going to talk about the haul I've gotten, which, of course, isn't very much as usual. I did see this. Raise the Roof. It's a witchy washi. They had it posted up at Acorns on their wall. I think it's an older pattern, but they re-released it or something because it wasn't up there before.
Oh.
And they were talking about it, but I can't remember everything
it's
they
very
said.
Cute.
So the pattern has kind of a brown fabric. I don't know if it says. Oh, flax.
Oh, flax.
So it's a flax. They had it in more like a grape purple fabric. It's very pretty.
On
very
the wall,
dark.
The
yeah, like almost eggplant or torch, you know, the darker grape. I thought that was a very good idea. So I went and dyed my own fabric at home because I couldn't find the fabric that I wanted there at their store. Mm. So I'm like, I'll make my own for crying out loud. So there we go. This is much more of like a pinky grape color and not the deep purple that they had on their sample, but I still think with the green in it that it's going to be adorable. And I can't wait.
Cool.
It comes, it has a whole bunch of buttons that you put on here. So the crow, there's another
one. Is he a button?
There.
The
yep.
Crow?
Yep. Aww. And there's a, let me see, there's a cat down here that's one. There's a pumpkin, there's a bat, there's a spider, there's a bug. So there's a whole bunch of fun little buttons that you get to add to it, but I love her bra.
That's
so cute.
That's
oh, so the other haul I got, if you watched us from the beginning, I had mentioned that I had signed up for Fabric of the Month from Color Cascade, which is in Australia, but I'd seen other floss tubers who had gotten their fabric, and I just thought, this is great. I love it. It's beautiful. And then I got, after a couple months, I finally got my first one. And they didn't get anything. So they were having a problem getting in the Belfast, apparently. So I got 4 months all at once. We finally got it, and they sent it to me. So I'm just going to show you some of the... There's that. I'm not going to open it all the way up. Nice raspberry kind of one.
The light in here is real nice. You can
yeah.
see the colors real nicely.
There's one.
Very pretty.
And then this is a really soft one. It's got...
Oh, yeah, that one's really cool.
Greens and pinks and yellows mm-hmm. in it, so it's real pretty and soft. So...
It's like sherbet.
Yeah. So those are my, finally, my fabrics that I've been waiting months and months and months for. So that's the only haul I have, the new ones. Do you have any new haul?
You know, I have some haul, but I really didn't bring a lot today. I do have one thing, though, that I, yes. Okay, everyone knows that I love my Marianne and her Snippeties. Love them. But I also really love Kelly Stadola, That's So Kelly Co. Her Bitsy Bobs, and especially her custom ones. This one is a custom Bitsy Bob Cutie. It is killer. Look at this, people. The back is gingham. It's got her cute little custom floss holder. It's got a little pocket here, and it's got a custom little, look at that scissor bob with the little bee. Love it. So it just fits right in there.
It almost seems like it would work for a needle holder, too.
Oh, yeah. Oh, it's
like you
totally
just kind stick it
leave
in
it on in the, yeah. So this is where you do your floss, and I love bees. I mean, this is my bee necklace I wear all the time. So I love this. This is so fun. Kelly, awesome. Yeah. So cool.
Yeah. That looks like something Beth Twist would have. Yeah. Or if she doesn't, yeah. She needs it.
Yes.
With all her bees.
All the bee people, you need one of those.
Yeah.
So cool.
Alrighty. As usual, I don't have a lot of whips. I didn't bring it, but I am still working on the Esther's Wave. It's going much slower than the other rose, or the more recent rose, just because it takes a lot more thought.
It's like a really big one, too.
It's just, it takes a lot more thought to do it. And it's,
and it's like you're almost your last row, too, right? Nothing like waiting until the very end to have like the hardest row.
Yeah. So, I am still working on the Mr. and Mrs. Delicious.
Okay.
I actually brought Mrs. Delicious to kind of compare sizes, because I mentioned last time that I did it on 28 count, and I'm actually doing both of them on 28 count, but Mrs. Delicious is on 28 over 2 threads, and right. Mr. is over 1 thread.
Right.
So he's a lot tinier, so here's my progress on him. Let me get my fabric out of the way a little better. So he's got his hat, and he's got a head. I did a little bit more of his body, but I haven't worked a lot. He's kind of been in timeout because he's frustrating me. Over one is not fun.
A lot, you have to concentrate
a lot more. Yeah. But here is Mrs. So you can see kind of the difference in size.
Mm-hmm. And you said, are you going to redo her in the one over one to match him?
I'm going to wait and see when he's done and see if I really like it enough to go through the effort to make another one.
Sure.
You know, in life, a lot of times the female birds are bigger than the male birds. I might not do anything to her.
And you know what? Again, there's no rules. There's no rule to say that Mrs. Delicious can't be just
bigger. And between the size she is and the size he is, they both would fit in the pan.
There you go. It's a good deal.
I had done one of the Mill Hill kits. I did the yellow bird a while, you know, about a month ago, and now I've started the blue bird. So we'll show you how far I've gotten on him. So pretty much the bird, except the bee. The bird is done. It's all the swirls and the trees and flowers and stuff that I still have to do. Very cool. And of course the beading, because that always gets done last.
Yeah.
So that's really all I'm working on right now.
Awesome. I have, okay. So I didn't bring a lot of my whips. I have to just confess and tell everybody, I have been busy working on scissor fobs. That's been my sole focus, really, truly. Stitchapalooza is this weekend. I've got to get as many done as I can. I'm still not going to have as many as I wanted. They are more time consuming than you think. They go fast, but at the same time, it's the putting together the colors.
Yeah,
and
twisting
the,
all the
yeah,
wires.
Yeah, it takes longer than you think. So I said I was going to start working on my peacock style, if any of you, this is it. And I'm starting on this, and you're going to laugh, because I officially started it, people. I'm so thrilled I started it.
Well, you know, this is kind of like Stitch Mania, when people do a, you know, a new start every single day, they only do a little
10 stitches. So this is what I have.
Stitch Mania.
The color is gorgeous, though. Oh my gosh. It's very subtle, but the variegation is so pretty. So, super thrilled about that. So, I do have a start. And I wanted to mention, I forgot to bring it with me, and I'm so sorry, Garden of Erie. I've showed it. It's Plum Street Samplers. It's the play on Adam and Eve, but instead it's Frankenstein and the Bride of Frankenstein. Marion, Lisa Gomez, and I are doing a sale. We're starting on Saturday the 10th, which is Stitchapalooza. We decided to start, make Stitchapalooza the start of our sale. Yep. But I know it's late notice, but anyone who wants to do it, you are welcome. Please join in. We would love to have anybody come in and join it. There's no rules to this sale. If you can't start on the 10th, no big deal. Just join in when you can. And we're keeping it super simple, and I checked, there's no hashtag being used yet. We're just gonna do hashtag EerieSal. So hashtag EerieSal. And post your progress, and we would love to see it. So that would be so fun. Please join the three of us. It's going to be a blast.
Yeah.
And then I have my finish.
Yeah.
And you guys already saw it in the last video. I was almost finished. I killed myself that night trying to get it done, but I wanted to show the official. I am so embarrassed because I can't figure out where the chart is to show you the actual picture. And you guys know that I made some changes, but I'll just show it to you. So this is Witchy Poo by Teresa Kogut. I did it on 40 count cedar plank, which is like my new favorite fabric. But there she is. So I don't know. Can you see if you can see her in there? Awesome. I love her. She might be honestly one of my favorite stitches. I love her. She turned out
very cute,
so perfectly. So I love her. And then the only thing, other thing I want to say, I wanted to show something. A little while ago, Chris, my friend Chris, and I decided to do like a little tiny exchange. I had mentioned it. She saw a little sheep that I had done for someone, and she said, "Will you stitch that for me, and I'll send something to you." And I didn't finish it. I didn't FFO it, but I just stitched a little sheep. But it's so cute. So I want to show you what she sent me. She sent me this. That just the cutest little thing. It's just like on a little button back. But I love it. It's just so tiny and so cute. So I want to show that. So thank you, Chris. I forgot to shout you out and tell you how much I appreciate that. So thank you.
Well, yeah. I do have a couple of finished stuff to show. I had shown before that I had the floral fence. I started the last one, so it's the blue one.
Very pretty.
And it is finished.
I really like that one.
Yeah, I do too.
It is really cute.
Very fun. So all of them are now finished. I don't know if I'll be able to hold these very well so you can see them all, but we'll give it a shot.
Do you want me to help?
Sure. So you can kind of see all of them and their goodness.
I love how they've got that and then the stripes.
Mm-hmm.
That's really, really cute.
Yeah. And they're all slightly different flowers, the big one. Mm-hmm. It's all slightly different.
And who is that by? Who's the designer by again?
M Designs.
M Designs. I don't know if I know them. M Designs.
Yeah.
Very cute.
But it's just called Floral Fun 1, 2, and 3.
Nice. And it's just three in the series?
As far as I know, because it is... I mean, it's only 2017,
That's
so it's
cool.
Not super old. I did get it, you know, in a clearance band, so it wasn't.
Oh, okay. Neat.
It was from Starlight Citrus. They had, you know, they've got so many things that are older. So.
Yeah, because I'd never seen that until you showed.
Yeah.
Very cute.
I know on, it might have been, it's either one of Instagram or the YouTube, somebody mentioned, "Oh, I liked it so much I went and found it."
Oh, that's so neat.
We're inspiring others.
I love that. I love that we're enablers and we inspire.
Yeah.
Isn't that so fun?
The other finishes I have is I was doing Night Owl, and I had part of the moon done, most of the owl. Well, he's completely finished.
Cute.
And not only that, he's completely FFO'd finished.
Nice.
So I did this, and I did it with my pumpkin one too. I made the hanger with beads. A lot of people are doing this.
They're doing beaded hanger?
Mm-hmm. And a lot of times what they'll do is they'll use leftover beads from their kits.
Oh.
I did not do that because in these kits, the only beads you get, there's some black ones here and some silver ones here, as well as the sequins.
Mm.
This is not black and silver, clearly. Plus, there's not that many beads that it comes with because you don't need that many.
Right.
This was just beads that I had either left over from projects or I had bought from wherever.
Mm-hmm.
So I used my own beads for that.
Nice.
But it just, it kind of classes them, makes it look a little cuter. So I did that. As I finish, I showed this last time that I had finished Bunnies on the Beach, but I FFO'd it. And did I FFO it?
So, did she ever?
There it is.
Nice.
So I mounted it on foam board and put cording around it. This back here is just like a placemat for your table. I got it at a Tuesday morning clearance type thing, so it wasn't that I paid full price for it. And it just so happens that this blue matches perfectly with the blue.
It does.
It's amazing.
Very nice.
Then I've got some, this is actually really wide, but I just scrunched it up and sewed it. Stick for my yard. It's been run over and beat up a lot, so it looks great for beach.
It looks, yeah. This looks like driftwood.
Plants, like seagrass or something. So, all done. Yay! Hanging up.
Love it. So, I'm gonna get there someday. You know what, again, process stitcher.
Well, and it takes
for the joy.
Between whether you're making fobs or bags or doing your yard work or just other chores that you end up doing, mm-hmm. and then just sitting down to stitch, there's not a lot of time to FFO things.
I know. Okay, seriously, can I just say real fast? I was commenting to someone the other day. For some people, Priscilla and Chelsea are the be-all and end-all. For some, they're not their aesthetic. I personally love Priscilla and Chelsea. I think they're amazing. But here's my take on what... I don't know how they have enough hours in the day. Those two ladies are unbelievable.
Kind of like Michelle Bundy. She does all the things, and she magically has 48 hours for our 24.
I know. It's unbelievable. I'm stuttering. Yeah. I don't even know. I'm like, how do you do all of that? It is amazing. Yeah. And I mean, those two ladies, Priscilla and Chelsea, the gardening, the FFOing, the stitching, the children, I'm in awe. I mean, and that is not me, and I'm okay with that, but I'm still in awe.
Yeah.
Amazing.
Yeah. It's a lot of work. I know. I'm trying to get my yard done, and
I'm just trying to get
all the other things done, and I'm losing my mind. That's why when I talk about the summer flying by, it's like, okay, I just know how much I still need to get done. I've done a lot.
You need to do it before the rainy starts.
Oh my gosh, yeah.
And that's going to come.
I mentioned that September a lot of times is still really dry.
It is.
So I kind of have 2 months, but at the rate it's been flying by,
it's going to go fast.
I don't know. I'm going to have to recruit my son to do a lot of work outside after this weekend because, like you said, I've been just focusing on the stitching.
Yeah, we had something to get done. Yeah, yeah.
So yeah, fun. Do you want to do the giveaway winner now?
Sure. Do you have a thing to show?
Yeah. Yes, I do.
We had our giveaway. And this is the blooming teapot. It's so cute. I actually love this. It's a brand new kit. Like we said, it's not opened. It just got banged up at the store. So cool. It's, yeah, just cracked, but it's great. And so we had 6 people enter. I did the random generator. And Amy loves toads. You're the winner of the blooming teapot. Yay! So I know Wendy is really good about sending you a note, and she'll ship it out to you. But contact, leave your mailing information. Yep. I'm saying this all weird. I'm so sorry.
Wendy,
you say it better. I don't
know. Yeah, we need to get your address so we can send it to you.
Yes, that would help.
So either through the Floss Tube comments or Instagram, you know, private message. You could also Gmail us, Pixie Dust Stitchers, mm-hmm. if you want it more private. Yeah, yeah, I'm sure that leaving it on the Floss Tube may.
That's a good point. Yeah.
Maybe not there, but yeah.
Awesome.
Give it out to you.
Very cool.
A few things that are going on. Yeah, I did go on a camping trip this last weekend, a couple days ago, and none of my family wanted to go.
Did they go?
Nope. So this was a church group. I mean, we all had our own sites, but mm-hmm. there was like 40 families that went. So we had a big room, mm-hmm. But I went on my own, people. They don't want to go, I'll go anyway.
Because you love camping.
Yeah, and man, I used my little Fiat. I think everything that was on top of the car, attached to the back of the car, and the car was bigger than my old car, you know.
Oh, that's hilarious. Did you take your bike?
The circle, yeah.
Nice.
Yeah, so I had my bike attached, I had my kayak on top, I have a cargo rack on top, and I had the inside, not like full to the ceiling, but it was full. But it was a good time. It rained hard the first night.
Did you have to dig a trench around your tent?
No.
Or a moat?
But this is the first time I got a new tent because I had to have something I could put up myself. I mean, other people would have helped me if I'd asked. Mm-hmm. And they did help a little bit, but I could have done it myself. There's a big netting part over the top. And then there's a fly that you pull over it. I had attached the fly. There's like some bungee clip things to kind of keep it down.
Sure.
But what I didn't do, and I didn't know this, is that there's also some ties, some string ties that you
like anchor it down,
anchor into the ground. If you do that, the fly stretches over the tension rod.
Oh.
You know, that holds the tin up?
Yeah.
Because I didn't do that, the water collected on top of the fly. I woke up about 2:30 with water dripping on. I mean, it wasn't a lot. It was like drip, and then
that's not fun. No.
5 or 10 minutes later, got another drip. I'm like, I better find out what's going on, even though it's still raining.
Mm-hmm.
And my ceiling was sagging because of all the rain, so I pushed it up. I didn't sleep really that night because I was worried that it was going to have more problems. And once every half hour, I get dripped on, so it wasn't terrible. But I found a stick. And occasionally I would just lay in bed and poke the top of the ceiling to get the water to drain off. But once we tied those down, it worked perfect. It worked the way it's supposed to. I thought there was a design flaw in the whole tent, but it was just user problems. And we didn't have rain the second night, which was great because then things got to dry out a little better before you shove them all back in your car.
We now have a visitor. We don't know him.
But there's somebody behind us down there. Yeah. So yeah, it was a lot of fun though. We had a blast. So.
Well, I had my parents came this weekend.
Oh.
And it was so much fun. My dad is, I've told some of you before, his side fun job is he is a boxing judge and an MMA judge. And he had a boxing event in Portland. And I love that because when he comes up, my mom comes up too, and she gets to hang out with me, and I love it. And so they came, and I got to see my dad for a couple minutes, and then he went back down. And my mom and I hung out, and she and I went out to dinner. And it was so cute because my husband was actually home this weekend, but he knows how much I love my mom time. So yeah. He's like, you two just go out. So he stayed home and the two of us went out and had just an awesome time. And then we stayed up super late just visiting. And it was so cute because some of my friends were like, what are you gonna do? Do you have any activities planned? And I'm like, honestly, no, because when my mom comes, I just want to see her.
Yeah.
Just being with her in the same vicinity and being able to hug her and touch her and talk to her is the best. And my mom and I are big reminiscers, so we'll spend like a lot of our time just talking about like our road trips to Minnesota. Or I mean, that's just what we do. My mom and I are very huge reminiscers, and so we love to talk about things that mean something to us. And and it's so cute because she knows things. So I was mentioning music, and I was saying something about how I used to have a CD that was from 1982, and it had Jessie's Girl on it, and Physical by Olivia Newton-John, and Queen of Hearts. And I said, Mom, do you know why, one of the reasons why I love this song? She goes, yeah, because that's Texas. Because we lived in Texas in 81, 82, and those were the three songs that were on the radio and super popular. So she knew, and so it's just fun. And so it was, we can do that on the phone too, but it was more fun in person. And then the next day, my husband was still home, and my dad, they stayed the night at our house, and we went to breakfast together. And it was great. It was wonderful. Loved it.
Yeah.
Good times.
Excellent. Fun stuff. Alrighty. Anything else?
Nope.
New things going on?
Okay. So now we have our breaking news.
Yeah.
Da da da. Wendy and I are going to have our own channels.
Yes.
This has been so much fun.
Yeah.
It has been wonderful because I know that if we hadn't done this, I probably would have never jumped into it.
Yeah, it kind of kicked our butts into doing it.
It really did. Mm-hmm. And it's been really fun and having somebody to share with. But, you know, I think between the distance that we have, it's not terrible, really. It's hard.
It's hard to coordinate two people's schedules when they're busy and they live far enough away.
Exactly. It's between that and, you know, we have slightly different visions. And I don't think that either of us should have to compromise the fun that we want to have. And this, anyway, I'm stuttering, but we are so excited to have our own channels.
Yeah.
And so I'm going to let Wendy go and explain.
Okay. So I'll have Instagram too. Yeah. I mean, we probably both will have stuff with that. My channel, the reason I picked the name for mine is because I'd actually started an Etsy shop and I decided just to use that same name. And that way it's consistent across for everything.
Makes total sense.
So it's much easier to find. So mine is going to be Wendy in Neverland.
Which makes sense because you love Tinkerbell.
Yeah. So it's kind of coordinated with this kind of channel as well, and everything is going on with that. So the only thing is kind of the way that you type it in is a little different for each of them. And my name is spelled with an I. so right. That might be a little bit harder for people to find. But for the floss tube, there's spaces between the words. For Instagram, there's an underscore between the words.
Oh, okay.
And I don't know why I ended up doing it this way, but Instagram, I think it runs all together.
Sure.
So
sure.
There's two I's next to each other, two N's next to each other.
Right. Yeah, it does. The Instagram just shoves it all together.
Yeah, yeah. So you can't really space it out, but I like the thing where you can see the different words. I know Beth Twist and some other people do that. They've got an underscore so you can see the two parts of their name or whatever. So, I mean, playing around, you'll probably find me whichever way you're trying to look for it.
Yeah.
But, yeah. And it's going to be a little bit more of a vlog style. Because, like I mentioned, with camping, doing other things, there's so much going on in my life that it's... It tends to do that a little more.
Yeah. And mine's going to be predominantly cross-stitch. I mean, I am going to share my life. I'm going to share things as I go. But I want you to know me. But it's going to be predominantly cross-stitching. And mine is Stitch Goes My Heart. So it's Stitch with an exclamation point, Goes My Heart. And it's a play on the movie music and lyrics. I mean, there's a couple reasons. Because stitching has my heart. It is my passion and my love. So... Stitch Goes My Heart. But it's also a play on music and lyrics, the movie with Hugh Grant and Drew Barrymore. And Hugh Grant's character, if you don't know, he is an aging 80s pop star. And they have a song called Pop Goes My Heart. And it's hilarious. And I actually already, in my head, I've resung the words to make it fit cross-stitch. Because I'm hilarious that way. At least I think I am. So anyway, it's Stitch Goes My Heart, and I would love you to come over.
Yeah.
Now here's the thing. I have a channel already. Wendy has her channel.
Yep.
I think, do you have a video up
already? I do have a video.
She has a video. I have a video up already. So just for ease of you guys being able to find us.
Yeah.
And I still haven't decided what I'm going to do about Instagram. I set up an Instagram, but I'm actually thinking it has been really hard having two accounts. It has been killing me going back and forth between my personal account and the Pixie Dust Stitchers account. I'm actually thinking about possibly just using my personal account, which is it's Super Chic 1976, but it's super chic. So it's SuperChic 1976. That's my handle on Instagram, and it's private right now, but you can send me a friend request. I'm thinking that might just end up being now my everything, because it's just, I can't go between two accounts.
Because I've been doing that too.
I'm trying to like everything, and it's too hard. And so, but I want you guys to follow me, so yes. So Stitch Goes My Heart on FlossTube and SuperChic 1976 on Instagram.
Yeah.
And what we're going to do is we're going to keep Pixie Dust Stitchers channel up. We won't, after this video, we will not be posting anything else to it. But we're going to keep it up because people might still find us.
Come back and watch.
Come back and watch older videos. And then when they get to video number 11, they'll find out that we've moved on and they'll be able to find our channels.
Yeah.
But we will be closing the Pixie Dust Stitchers Instagram account. We're going to post when this video comes out as an alert and some... messages to you. Wendy will post an alert, but
I'll
like
put it under the comments and stuff with our channel.
Okay.
Name
sure.
as well, so that way everybody has that in writing as well as hearing it.
Sure. Perfect. And so I will do that. We'll let it go for maybe a week or two, and then we'll be closing that account. So other than that, that's it. But I just want to thank everyone. This has been an incredible journey.
Yes.
I have loved it. I have loved
it. And we're still friends.
Absolutely.
It's not like we're separating.
No, it's nothing. No, it's just life.
Yeah.
And it's okay.
Yeah.
And it's going to be fun. And we're still, now you have two new channels to watch.
That's right.
I mean, come
on. Twice the fun, man.
Good stuff, people. So it's going to be fun. We've got a fun-filled weekend coming up, and it's going to be busy. I got to get home and got to do lots of stuff.
Got some work to do. That's right.
Me too. Yep. So, but again, thank you. You guys have been awesome.
Thank you
for following us, for giving us love, and just appreciating what we do, for letting us hopefully inspire you, bring you comfort and joy. So, thank you.
Yeah. So, we'll see you around. Hopefully
see you around.
On your channels.
Bye.